Hello students, let us proceed further. Here we have a circuit, so we need to solve for node voltages here. So first step we are going to do is we are going to find number of principal nodes. So here we have number 1, 2, and 3. So we have 3 nodes here, n equal to 3. So number of equations we are going to get is n minus 1, that is 2. Okay, so third step is we are going to assign node voltages v1, v2, v3, and v3 is taken as reference node. Okay, so fourth step is we are going to apply KCL at node 1. Okay, so I am going to assign node voltage V1, V2 and V3. V3 is 0 volts, you already know, which is having 0 reference. So applying KCL at node 1. So for that I am going to take currents leaving the node 1. Okay, so according to KCL, I1 plus I2 plus I3 must be equal to 0. So what is I1 here? I1 is potential difference V1 minus V by R1, and I2 is V1 minus 0 by R2. And what is I3 here? This is very important. So what is I3 here? V1 minus V2. So here we have a voltage source of Vx. So how can you find current through this voltage source without any resistance value? So here we need to find current I3 here. So what is the value of current I3? How can you find this? So here between two nodes we have a voltage source and we need to find current through that voltage source. How can it is possible to find current through this voltage source? So here we get a new concept, that is called super node. Okay, so here we get a new concept, that is called super node. So in super mesh concept, so if there is a current source between two meshes, if there is a current source between two meshes, so we treat this, we neglected, we ignored this current source and we assumed this total mesh as a one mesh, that is called super mesh. We ignored current source between two branches, two meshes. But here between two nodes we have a voltage source here. In mesh analysis we got current source between two meshes. In nodal analysis we get voltage source between two nodes. Okay, so here also we are going to ignore this voltage source and we are going to treat as, here this is node 1, this is node 2, right? So we are going to treat these two nodes are combined nodes, that means these two nodes are one node. Okay, so these two nodes are treated as one node and this, the treated node is called super node. I hope you are getting some sense now. So earlier we ignored this current source between two meshes to obtain the voltages in the loop, that is called super mesh. This entire mesh is called super mesh. Here we are going to ignore this voltage source and we are going to treat these two nodes as one node, that is called super node. Okay, then we are going to solve for these current source, sorry, voltage, node voltage, then we can get the respective current. So here Vx is voltage source which is having the voltage of V1 minus V2. Okay, so now let us proceed further. So let us take one circuit, let us take this circuit and we are going to solve for node voltage. Okay, so here one way to overcome this difficulty is to apply the super node technique. In this method the two adjacent nodes are connected by voltage source are reduced to one single node and then equations are formed by applying KCL as usual. Okay, so let us try to solve this network using super node concept. Okay, now we are going for super node concept. So now I am going to apply super node concept to this circuit. So for that I am going to ignore this voltage source and I am going to treat these two nodes are connected nodes, that is combined node. Okay, so I am going to write super node equation for node 1. Okay, so here instead of KCL at node 1 I am going to write super node equation, KCL at super node, that is node 1 and 2. Okay, so 1 and 2 are treated as super node, that means they are connected to one node, they are treated, so this line means they are short circuited, so that means they are connected to one node. So that means I1, sorry, so let us write the equations here. Okay, so here the currents will be sum of the currents at two nodes, so I1 plus I2, so this current is unknown, so this is I3, so this is I4, so we have four currents at our super node. Okay, so we need to take current set node 1 as well as node 2 for a super node equation, okay? So because these two are connected, okay? For one super node equation, we are going to get two node currents here, okay? That is important. So that means I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4 must be equal to 0, okay? So these are the currents at super node. Now let us write for I1, I2, I3, I4. So I1 is V1 minus, this is V, right? V by R1 plus V1 by R2 for I2, and at node 2 we have I3, that is V2 by R3, V2 minus 0 by R3 actually, so I am writing directly, okay, V2 by R3 plus V2 by R4 plus R5. So this is our super node equation, and voltage of our voltage source between two nodes is Vx is V1 minus V2, okay, difference of two node voltages. So this is important. So let us take one problem so that you can understand it clearly, okay? So this is about super node. So super node concept will be applicable when there is a voltage source between two nodes, okay? So then we are going to treat two nodes as one node, that is called super node, and we are going to write equations for currents at both the nodes into one equation, okay? So let us take one problem. So here is a problem. Determine the current in the 5 ohm resistor. So here we have a 5 ohm resistor. We need to find current through this resistor, okay? So how can you find this current? So he didn't mention anything about nodal analysis. We need to think that which method will be suitable to find current through this 5 ohm resistor, okay? So let us see how can you find this current through this 5 ohm resistor. So that is possible when we find this voltage V, and here the current will be, let us assume it as I. So I will be V minus 10 ohms, V minus 10 volts by 5 ohms will be current through our resistor 5 ohms. Okay, you need to find voltage here, okay? That is called node voltage. So node voltage can be found only when nodal analysis, when we apply nodal analysis, okay? So node voltage V can be found by applying nodal analysis. So we are going to apply nodal analysis here, okay? So there is a way we can find current through 5 ohms resistor. So he just asked to find current through 5 ohms resistor. We need to think about the suitable method to find current through it. Okay, so that is possible by finding voltage between two terminals of resistor. So we have a voltage at one terminal, that is 10 volts, and we need to find voltage at another terminal, other terminal of our 5 ohms resistor. So that is node voltage. Okay, so node voltages can be found using nodal analysis. Okay, so that is the way of thinking to solve a network. Okay, so you can pause the you can pause this video and you can solve for your own. Okay, and compare the results at the end. Okay, you don't need to follow me. Now I'm going to apply nodal analysis here. Okay, so first thing we are going to do is we are going to find number of super nodes here, principal nodes, sorry, principal nodes. So this is node 1. So let me take it as node 1. So this is our second principal node, and this is your third principal node. So you have three principal nodes at the top and one principal node at the bottom. So I'm going to treat this principal node as reference node, which has zero potential. Okay, so we have four nodes. So number of equations will be n minus 1 will be 3. Okay, so let us assign the node voltage V1. So I am writing it faster so that you can understand it. Okay, so this is V4. Okay, now I am going to apply KCL at node 1. Okay, so I am going to apply KCL at node 1. So the current must leave the higher potential. So we treat the potential at treated respect to node is higher. So I1 plus I2 plus I3 must be equal to 0 according to KCL. Okay, so I1 is opposite to 10 volt, 10 amperes. So I'm going to write negative E here because it is opposite. So I2 will be V1 minus 0 by 3, that will be V1 by 3, plus I3 will be V1 minus V2 by 2 ohms. So this is our equation 1. Now let us apply KCL at node 2. So I'm going to apply KCL at node 2. So let us write currents here. So this is I4, I am treating them I4, I5, here I6. Okay, here observe that I6, we cannot find I6 here because we have a voltage source between two nodes. So how can you find the current here? So here we can ignore this voltage source and we can treat node 2 and node 3 as one node, that is called super node. So we have a super node at between 2 and 3, that is we have a super node at node 2 and 3. Okay, so I'm going to write KCL equation for super node. So for that I am going to write current at node 2 as well as node 3. So the current at node 2 is I4, I5 and here I6, this is I7. Okay. So these are the currents for super node. Okay. So these two are super nodes. Okay. So let us write I4. I4 is V2 minus V1 by 2. I4 plus I5 plus I6 and I7 must be equal to 0. Okay. So I'm going to find I4 equal to V2 minus V1 by 2. I'm writing directly I5 is V2 by 1 plus I6 is V3 minus 10 by 5 plus I7 is V3 by 2 will be equal to 0. Okay. So here we have this V2 minus V3 is 20 volts. The given 20 volts is between V2 and V3. So V2 is higher potential because it is positive and V3 is negative. So 20 volts is V2 minus V3. This is third expression. Okay, we have obtained three equations here. Okay, so earlier in the super mesh, we would be having one equation for that super mesh current source. That is I equal to some I1 minus I2 something. So similarly for super node also, we are going to get expression for the voltage source. So V2 minus V3 will be our value of voltage source. Okay, so here we have three equations. So we are going to solve for V1, V2, V3. So we need to find the current through 5 ohms resistor, that is I6 in our example. So I6 is V3 minus 10 by 5. We need to find V3 so that we can find the current through 5 ohms resistor. Okay, so by solving the equation 1, 2 and 3, we are going to get the values of V1, V2, V3. So we need V3 here. V3 is, by solving the equations, we are going to get V3 as V3 equal to minus 8.42 volts. So I want you to solve for these three equations and I want you to get these values. So current through 5 ohms resistor will be, so I am going to substitute V3 here. So current through 5 ohms resistor is I6 here, V3 minus 10 by 5. So V3 is minus 8.42 minus 10 by 5. So the current through 5 ohms resistor, that is I6, is minus 3.68 amperes. That means current, we assumed I6 is downwards, but the actual current is flowing upward. That is why we are getting the minus. So the actual I6 is flowing opposite, flowing upward. I can say upward. Okay, so this is how we are going to get the currents through each element when we have a voltage source between two nodes. Okay. So this is one example for super node. So I am going to give you one circuit as assignment. Okay. So I want you to do one circuit for assignment so that you can get the basic idea. Okay. So let me give you assignment. So here is third question for your assignment 5. So I want you to determine the power dissipated by 5 ohms resistor in the circuit. So this is the circuit. Okay. So this is little different, but you can solve this. Okay. So if you have gone through all the videos I have explained so far, you can solve this equation, this circuit. So if you can solve this circuit, I treat that you have obtained the basic idea about solving the circuit. Okay. So this is a basic test for you. Okay. So there is nothing actually. So you need to find power dissipated by 5 ohms resistor. So this is 5 ohms resistor. So for that you need to, so this is reference node, 0 volts. Okay. In the question also, it is mentioned. Okay, this is reference node. Okay, so you need to find the current through this 5 ohms resistor. So that is only possible. So you have a potential 0 at one end of 5 ohms resistor. So other end voltage you need to find. So that is possible by applying nodal analysis. Okay, so you need to find the principal nodes. Okay, so this is first node, second node, third node, this is reference node. Okay, so you have three nodes and four nodes actually. So you have four nodes, you can apply nodal analysis. So at node, so currents are 1, 2, 3 and 4, and at this second node also you have four currents leaving the node, and at this node we have three currents leaving the node. Okay, so just don't panic. Okay, just try to apply your basic principles here. Okay, so here the voltage will be V3 minus V3 minus of minus 40. Here the terminal is minus, so V3 minus of minus 40 will be your current. So this current will be V3 minus, this current will be V3 minus minus of 40 by 4 ohms will be this current, and there is nothing else actually. So here you will be having a super node concept. That means node 2 and node 3 will be super nodes. So you are going to assume them as one node and you are going to write one equation for two nodes. That means the currents will be this current, this this will come in one equation. Okay, by solving that you are going to get V3 value, so that you can get the current through 5 ohms resistor, so that you can find power through that resistor. You need to find V3, then current through 5 ohms resistor, then you can solve for power through our resistor 5.